Hey, glorious geeks. The news this week around the world has been insane as per usual, but I'm only gonna focus on two stories because I've had no electricity, Wi-Fi, or reception, making things a little bit more difficult than usual. What are you gonna do? As per usual, don't forget to click the subscribe button and follow us and like this video. This story hits home for me. I'm a proud American of Lebanese descent and I have a lot of family in Lebanon. This week, a massive explosion took place there in the capital's port that I swear you could only see in movies. You have to see this insane footage. Not only was the port absolutely decimated and the area around it, but homes and hospitals as far as 20 miles away sustained damage. Even Cyprus felt the reverberations, and that's 150 miles away. Currently, the death count is well over 100, with thousands injured, but numerous people remain missing, and 300,000 people are now homeless. The cause of the blast isn't totally clear, other than that gross criminal negligence on the part of the Lebanese government is one of the key factors. An enormous stockpile of ammonium nitrate sitting at the port essentially became a ticking time bomb. I had never really heard about ammonium nitrate before this, so just quickly for your understanding, it's basically a highly dangerous and explosive material. It's the same one that was used in the Oklahoma City bombing, but that was 2 tons of it, and what was sitting at the Beirut port was 2,750 tons, so you do the math. We don't yet know what triggered the blast, but President Trump went out ahead of the Lebanese government to say his generals told him it looked like a bomb of some kind. He gave no more details though, so that was helpful. This would be a tragedy anywhere, but when you add this to the fact that the country is facing a significant economic crisis, I mean like Venezuela level, the currency has lost 60% of its value over the last few months, and you add rising coronavirus cases, it's a devastation and horror that's hard to wrap your mind around. I'm not here to speculate why or how this blast started, but I'll tell you the two most important things. First, the Lebanese government has not only been rife with endemic corruption, but an ineptitude and incompetence you could only see if toddlers ran the country. Like, no joke, my 4-year-old son could do better. The ammonium nitrate that was sitting at this port has been there for 6 years, and the government knew about it. Why such dangerous chemicals sat there for so long, stored so unsafely, and right next to people, we also don't know. And why no one moved or disposed of it is outrageous, criminal, and beyond comprehension. Accountability is necessary, and while I'm usually a glass half full kind of gal, I worry that accountability may never be served because it has never been served in Lebanon. Lebanon has suffered through assassinations, a serious trash crisis, and pollution that literally causes cancer, and yet perpetrators never pay. The irony is that those who are the most culpable, like the president and the prime minister, have gone out and promised to hold those responsible accountable. Well, that's great. If they want to hold people accountable, then they should call for an international criminal investigation. Then they should buy themselves some tickets to The Hague, where they and their predecessors can stand trial before the International Criminal Court. Accountability will then certainly be served. The Lebanese government is on my list this week. The most important thing we can all do now is to help urgently provide humanitarian assistance. Organizations like the Lebanese Red Cross, Off Joie, and Impact Lebanon are just a few of the ones doing amazing work there to help those in need, and so they're on my crush list this week. I'll tag them on my Twitter and Instagram, or you can go to ohmyworld.tv if you'd like to donate. For the families of victims and the Lebanese who are in despair, my thoughts and prayers are with you. I know there are no words other than to tell you that you and Lebanon will see brighter days, and I do think the international community will come in to help. I'm going to share a saying that a friend told me. To love Lebanon is to live with heartbreak. Here's hoping for a better future. Last week, President Trump threatened to ban TikTok in the United States because of concerns that the Chinese government would be able to steal our privacy data. Is this a real national security threat, or did TikTok get in the middle of the US-China pillow fight? Basically both. It's not yet proven that TikTok gives our data to the Chinese government, at least not publicly. But is it possible? Yeah. TikTok is owned by a Chinese parent company called ByteDance. And while TikTok has said it doesn't hand data over to the Chinese government, it doesn't mean the Chinese couldn't force its hand. Now listen, I knew about this, and honestly, I still had a TikTok account. And I did my own fair share of dancing, because let's face it, it's a whole lot of fun. TikTok saved me during lockdown. It also stole hours of my life I will never get back. But the threat is real. A number of security companies have cautioned that TikTok collects a lot of data and that its parent company has close ties with the Chinese government. Most concerning is that TikTok's privacy policy leaves a door open to responding to government requests without specifying which governments. Bottom line, TikTok's mass collection of data could pose a real risk to privacy. It's also kind of the ugly stepchild in the US-China divorce. So in walks Microsoft, which could possibly be the marriage counselor for the US and China we've all been waiting for. Because if Microsoft can buy TikTok, or at least the US side to it, then it could protect our data from getting into the hands of the Chinese government. Trump originally said he would block Microsoft from buying TikTok, probably to prevent the Chinese parent company from making a big bunch of cash and to give China the middle finger. But when he saw the outrage from tweens everywhere, it may have helped change his mind. The sale is not that simple, though. First, because it's hard to just break off parts of a social media platform. And second, because now Trump is saying that the US Treasury should also get a cut from this deal. Right now, TikTok has been given 45 days to find a buyer or face a ban from the US market. It's also possible that if a sale does go through, the Chinese could retaliate against US businesses in China, since they might be pissed Trump will force the sale. We don't totally know how it'll unfold, and either way, it'll be a dent in the US-China relationship. But in the meantime, we can all keep dancing. Geeks, it's been a week. Please hit the subscribe button below and like this video. Leave me a comment or question, or let me know if there's a story you want me to talk about. And please follow Oh My World and me on Instagram and Twitter. Stay fabulous, geeks.